Okay, so we're going to talk about the like the ins and outs of this turkey. This is for people who don't never, ever, ever cook a turkey in their life. This is the other piece I had left over that I just took off. I'm just one-handed, y'all, so please forgive me. If you see any of these stuff on here, take it off. Nobody want to see the feathers and stuff. We know it has feathers, but nobody wants to see that when they're trying to eat the turkey. So make sure you clean your turkey good, y'all, okay? Now, another thing that you didn't know about the turkey is that there's a little button. I call it a button, but some people call it other stuff. There's a little button on the turkey. Where'd it go? I'm trying to find the button, y'all. Give me 1 minute. I'm trying to find the button. Hold on. Where'd it go? Find a button. There's some stuff in here you need to be taking out. So anybody who don't know, this stuff right here is the gizzard, liver, all that stuff. You want me to cook it, but you need to really take all this stuff out the turkey. Don't cook the turkey with this stuff in here, okay, y'all? Please take it out the turkey. Get your hand in there. They got the neck. Oh, I'm trying to. Hold on, y'all. Trying to wiggle this out. Hold on, give me 1 minute. I gotta put this camera down. Lower the camera down. No light. Okay, when you push them legs back, everybody, you got this stuff in the turkey neck. We're gonna take that out. The neck will take out. Anything else? No, nothing else. Now, this thing, you don't have a button. I'm surprised. Use a little piece of little button somewhere to just tell you when it's ready. You get a little button. This thing don't have it. I don't know what's going on with this turkey, but you can definitely tell them the turkey is ready, so that's fine. Now we're going to wash this turkey. Okay, we're going to wash all the turkey and it's going to start seasoning. Pat it dry and season. Pat the canola oils and make sure this is fully good to go and oiled down before I actually add the seasoning and of course the batter. So, like I said, y'all, this is an easy peasy recipe, not too much to it. And this bird will be cooking real good in a second. This chicken is very oiled down. I want y'all to see. Oiled down. It's oiled down. There's a slight green to it. Let's get this seasoned, this bad boy. So, the thing I like to do, I like to season one side, then put it in the rotisserie. And then season and coat the other side. That way I can easily season it and not fall off in this glorious roasting pan I have it, okay? So I got to tell you, I like to use butter or margarine, whatever people like to call margarine. It's not, and I like to take the little of that seasoning on my hand. And just butter this bad boy down also with some margarine. So, again, I'm sorry, I'll use margarine too. Another tip, y'all. I think this is this part right here. I'm going to coat it in butter and then put another layer of the flour, the powder on. Just to make sure it's nice and sticky. So, as you see how that butter looks, after I put it on, I'll put the batter back on again and we'll see it again, okay? This is how I look with the butter on it. And I'm going to put another coat of this oven fried chicken mix on it, okay? And I'll show you how it looks before I put it. And it's rotisserie and get it cooking. I'm going to put some water in the rotisserie, just add a little water to the bottom, but we're almost there. That's how it looks before we get it, this bad boy, in the rotisserie, okay? We're going to have it on 350 and just let it cook. I'll be back when it's done. Deck